I remember the first time that Oliver brought Katie home to meet the family. Oliver's bedroom was upstairs in our house, and there was a bit of a rumpus room. We had an old rowing machine that had been packed away for years and hadn't been used. But with Katie coming over, the rowing machine somehow managed to find its way into the middle of the room, polished up with some sweaty rags hanging off it.
As the boys were growing up, Peter and I, of course, gave them plenty of advice and direction. Two things I distinctly remember saying to them as they were growing up was to always get on well together. And I also told them that as I didn't have any daughters, they all had to have lovely wives. And they listened. So today I feel very fortunate and indeed very, very happy to welcome the lovely Katie as my third lovely daughter-in-law.
Katie and Oliver had declared before all of us their love and commitment. By the virtue of authority vested in me, and with the very best wishes of all your family and friends present here today, I have much pleasure in declaring you to be husband and wife. Oliver, you may kiss your beautiful bride.
There's a school of thought out there, I know, some of you have been talking about it, that Katie is perhaps too good for me. I'm not here to confirm or deny that, but I do recognise I'm a very lucky man to be standing here this evening. Katie, you are the kindest, most thoughtful and beautiful person I've ever met, and I'd like to thank you for the way you've changed my life. I wake up excited every day and go to bed happy every single night until I look at you. I'll never tire of loving you and treating you like a queen. And I hope you never tire of loving me and telling me what to do because I need it. I love you with all my heart and always will.
Gonna give all my worries away.